So this is where they've been sending these.
Wolf.
The big bad wolf. You used to be something. They used to fear you. They'd hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit. About time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way, now. Don't make this worse.
Aw. He doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Wow. What a man. Stealing punches while my back is turned. Didn't your mother ever teach you to fight proper?
Hey!
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds 6 rounds of special...
I won't miss next time.
Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the Woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want. You plan to do what she says, don't you?
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial. Are we clear?
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that? Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Maybe you didn't carry it out. But I don't think Georgie was lying when he said you ordered their deaths.
Georgie would have said anything to save himself. We both know that. I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of them. Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth, or do you just want to look like the hero?
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. 2 people were murdered.
And you know who did it. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle. You know, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Miss White again. My previous interactions with her have gone rather well.
Oh, I don't think so. We're not doing this your way.
How unfortunate. I was hoping we could make this work.
What are you gonna do now? Rip me apart like some kind of animal? Killing me here would achieve nothing.
And what would Miss White think?
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.